The futures exchange is where futures orders are received. Buy and sell orders are matched to create what is referred to simply as the market. The exchanges have the objective to provide fast and accurate order execution and to maintain an orderly market. Brokerages play an important role in the futures markets as they are the link between the trader and the futures exchange. Brokers have many functions in the futures market. The primary functions are providing a software platform to place orders, manage client deposits, and connect traders to the exchange. Since individual traders cannot interact directly with the exchange, they need to rely on a broker who can send their orders to the exchange and manage the flow of money between the exchange and the trader's accounts. When selecting a broker, there are a few things that a trader should consider: technology, cost, and trading permissions. In the past, orders were telephoned into a broker who would place the order with the exchange. Now that trading is fully electronic and the technology available to individual traders is the same as institutional traders, orders are placed directly through a broker's online platform. The technology of a broker's platform will allow traders to place orders, perform analytics, and create systems that can trade automatically based on predefined conditions. Traders pay fees for the software they use and their executed trades. There are typically three fees a trader will pay: 1. Commissions. 2. Platform fees. And 3. Data feed fees. Traders pay a fee to their broker each time an order is executed. Commissions have two components: a fee to the broker and a fee that the broker forwards onto the exchange. Depending on the brokerage, the fee might be per contract or a flat fee per trade in addition to the fee per contract. Some brokers will charge a monthly platform fee. This fee is for the use of their software and is an addition to commissions. Depending on account size and number of trades executed each month, this fee may be reduced or waived. Fees may also be charged for deposits, withdrawals, and other services which will be listed in the brokerage agreement. Additionally, some traders might have to pay a data feed fee. These fees are charged by the exchange to provide real-time and historical price data that traders require for their charts. Depending on the brokerage, these fees might be built into the overall costs or might be charged per item. Brokers may have different restrictions and requirements. Individual traders should be aware of items that may affect their trading. The items include initial deposit amount, margin requirements, overnight trades, and futures contracts available to trade. Each broker will set an initial deposit amount that is required to open an account. This amount varies from broker to broker. Margin requirements are set by the exchange and are an important component of the futures market. The exchange sets standard margin rates for futures contracts. The overnight session in the futures market is treated differently than the day session. There is a rate set for normal trading hours and a higher rate set if traders hold the position overnight into the next trading day. These amounts can vary from broker to broker. There are many futures contracts available to trade, each with their own risk profile. Some futures contracts are more volatile and have large dollar values per tick, which is why some contracts will require larger accounts with special permissions to trade. For example, the E-mini is one of the first contracts to be enabled for a trader, whereas contracts such as natural gas may need to be requested to trade. Individual traders can find a broker that best suits their needs based on the broker's setup, costs, and permissions to trade.